Hello, Dr. Nisha. I wanted to ask about the different techniques of radiotherapy. Can you also explain me about the intensity modulated radiation therapy and image guided radiation therapy for lung cancer treatment?
Modern science is evolving by every passing day, and so is the branch of radiation oncology as well. The basic philosophy of radiation therapy is to deliver maximum dose or maximum damage to the tumor cells while giving away least amount of toxicity to the nearby structure. It is in this quest that we are developing newer and newer technologies. Before a few decades, we radiation oncologists used to treat our patients with what we call as 2D technique. In 2D conventional treatment, we used to take an X-ray and see the tumor, have a rough idea of where the tumor is, and then mark the tumor with reference to the bony margins, and then treat the tumor by putting some beams anteriorly and posteriorly or by the sides. Now, the problem with this kind of technique is that the tumor can be killed, but the normal structures that is coming in the way of the radiation beams are also damaged. Now, if we want to save the normal structures, we will have to compromise on the tumor dose, on the local control, and hence on the survival. And we used to give large margins in order to cover the inaccuracies. Such 2D treatments are not done, at least in a curative settings, for lung cancer anymore. In order to save the normal organs, but at the same time not compromise the tumor dose, we had developed something called as 3D CRT, or three-dimensional conformal radiation therapy. 3D CRT, or three-dimensional conformal radiation therapy, was developed next in order to save more of the normal structures while not compromising on the tumor dose. In this technique, instead of X-rays, we started taking CT scans to make sure that the tumor as well as the normal organs are marked in a three-dimensional way and not on a two-dimensional plane. In this technique also, we do the simulation. So as I had discussed, in this technique also, the simulation procedure is done and the CT scan is taken and the organs to be treated as well as the normal organs are marked. Beams are arranged in such a way that all the dose, that is the cumulative dose, goes to the treatment area or the desired treatment area, and the normal organs are receiving minimal radiation. In addition to structuring the beam or sending the beam through multiple angles, it is also shaped in a way that it treats the tumor in a conformal way. This is done with the help of multi-leaf collimators, wherein leafy structures form the shape of the tumors that is seen from the treatment angle. IMRT, or intensity modulated radiotherapy, was the next advancement in line. In this, we divided the beams into multiple beamlets, and each of these beamlets were modulated. If you compare 3D CRT with IMRT, it is like asking a child to draw a complicated painting by giving blocks versus paintbrush. Blocks is our 3D CRT and IMRT is our paintbrush. So you yourself can, make out as to which will give more conformality. With IMRT, we are able to do what is known as a dose painting. That is, we are able to deliver the dose even to a very curvy structure wherein the organ at risk is located very close to the target structure. We have special softwares and algorithms that will make sure that the desired dose is delivered to the tumor and the tolerances for each of the organs is met. In this way, we are able to deliver the desired dose to the treatment area while there is minimal dose to the adjoining structures. Now, IGRT, or image guided radiotherapy, is nothing but the using of images right from the simulation to the treatment execution. During the treatment, scans are taken to make sure that the patient is in the perfect position, and also the treatment is done only when the tumor is in a particular position. The images increases the accuracy of the treatment, thereby reducing the necessity of large margins and hence reducing the amount of the normal lung tissues or the normal structures that is coming into the high dose area. There is also one more technique that we called as volumetric arc radiotherapy, which is the most advanced form of radiation therapy, in which we deliver these beams not from one or six angles, but in the form of a continuous arc while modulating the treatment in all the positions. Hereby, I have given a synopsis of how radiation therapy has evolved from the two-dimensional era to an era wherein we use image guidance and volumetric arc therapies in order to make sure that the patient is treated in the most effective way. And hence, we can sort of say now that lung cancer treatment is very safe and there will be no long-term side effect because of these advanced technologies.